Hey everybody, how's it going? It's the Daily Shooter, and today I've got a comparison between two different very popular LPVOs. These are both 1-8s. We have the primary arms 1-8 with the ACSS reticle, and we have the Swampfox Optics Tomahawk 1-8 with the Gorilla BDC reticle. Now, this all kind of started because I got an email from somebody saying that they were looking at these exact two scopes and couldn't figure out which one to go with. So I kind of steered them in one direction based off of my opinion, but then I thought, you know what, might as well make a video about it because they are very comparable in a lot of ways, and the prices are also very comparable. The primary arms is coming in at about $389 on their website, and the Swampfox Optics is coming in at $399. Now, I only have a discount code for one of these. The Swampfox Optics, I have a 20% off discount code if you use code DAILYSHOOTER, and that's pretty much good for the entire website. You can get 20% off pretty much everything you want over there. So I have that, but that didn't really make my opinion on these two scopes. Okay, it wasn't the fact that I can get a discount on this one, so it makes it less expensive than this one, and so I would go with that. It really is the features and the way that these things are set up that made me determine which one of these would be a better buy. So let's go ahead and talk about the two of them. Now, in full transparency, and to prove that not one of these has like an advantage over the other one because I happen to be working with that company for reviews or something, both of these scopes were sent out to the channel by their respective companies for me to test out and review. Primary Arms sent this one out to me probably 3 years ago to test out and review, and the Swampfox Optics was sent out a little bit over a year ago to test out and review. So I've had both these scopes for a while, and they were both sent to the channel for me to test out. So I'm not picking one of these because I have any special relationship with either one, but I do definitely have a favorite of the two. Now, the Primary Arms I've been using the longest, and I think it's a good scope. It has a lot of nice features. It's a light scope. It has the ACSS reticle, which is absolutely one of my favorite reticles, but in my opinion, it just does not hold a candle to the Swampfox Optics Tomahawk. The Tomahawk has everything I wanted this one to have for pretty much the same price. So the first thing to me that comes to mind when I think about these two, and when people ask me the question, you know, which one would you rather get, is going to be the eye box. So the eye box on the Swampfox Optics Tomahawk is very, very forgiving, meaning that when I look through this, I feel like I get a full wall-to-wall picture of what I'm looking at. So instead of having, you know, this big blocky round thing and then this, you know, floating gray area when your parallax is off just a little bit, and you have to be dead on and still the picture is just kind of a little bit subdued, with this, it's again, seems like it's perfect HD clarity wall to wall when I look through it, and I have a lot of leeway with my eye where I don't have to be absolutely perfectly behind it in order to see a perfect image. It does give you a lot more to look through, in my opinion, whereas the Primary Arms, it's definitely less forgiving. There is a lot more material around the outside, meaning that the image that you're looking through is going to be quite a bit smaller, and then that ring, that gray ring that you get if your eye is just slightly off of the center of that aperture. If your eye is just slightly off, you're going to get a lot of gray, a lot of black, a lot of ring that shows up, which is going to obscure what's around your target. And so that is one thing I didn't like about the Primary Arms. It's a great scope, and it's served me well over the past 3 years. I've been using it on a rifle pretty much that entire time. So I can say that, you know, it's a good scope, but that's one thing that I really didn't like. The other thing that I would look at in a comparison, if I was talking to you out there right now and you were asking me questions, is going to be the turrets. So the Primary Arms has basic turrets. These are cap turrets. And when you take the turret covers off, like for instance on the top turret, it's very low profile, very small, and there is very little to grab onto if you're trying to make your adjustments. So it's 1/2 MOA clicks on here. It's 1/2 MOA clicks on here. So they both have 1/2 MOA clicks. They're both 1-8 by 24. So that's going to be exactly the same as well. The length is almost identical as well. I know there's not really a way to show this on camera, but the Swampfox Optics Tomahawk is maybe going to be 1/4 inch longer. But still, with these turrets, they're just not super easy to use, especially if it's cold outside, you have a gloved hand on. It's just not very easy to use, and the turrets are kind of hard to turn. I myself am not a huge fan of having capped turrets, but that's the way that they are. They're going to be low profile on both sides on the Primary Arms. on the Swampfox optics, we have these large tactical knobs. Now, these large tactical knobs have pretty heavy knurling all the way around, so you can get a good grab on it, a good grip on it, whether using your bare hand or you're using gloves, and they're easy to zero reset by removing the cap once you have your zero and replacing the zero portion right on this little slat on the back right here. So it's very easy to set a re-zero on the Swampfox optics. Again, same 1/2 MOA clicks that you're going to be making, a total of 100 MOA in travel. That means 50 up, 50 down, and so forth. We also have a large tactical knob on the side here. It's going to be the same way to set and reset your zero. Again, a lot of knurling, very easy to grab onto, and it's also easy to see with the caps on. If I want to make adjustments, I have to leave the caps off, right? With this, I just leave it the same way that it is right there, and I'm good to go. There's also an O-ring inside the primary arms, and without the cap on, I don't know that the primary arms would stay waterproof without the cap on, putting pressure up against that O-ring. I haven't tested that because I don't want to destroy my optic, but again, there is an O-ring in there as well. Now, another thing that I like about the Swampfox optics over the primary arms is going to be the magnification adjustment. So on the primary arms, we have a magnification adjustment that's located in the same spot as the Swampfox optics, but it is very, it's not very well pronounced, and the grip on this is certainly not as nice as on the Swampfox. There's basically just a little bit of jimping that goes around the scope itself, and then we have this small throw lever that kind of sticks up right here. So it's just like a little quarter inch throw lever that you can grab onto and you can make your adjustments. Now, I've had this thing for 3 years. It's not going to get any more worn in, but it is a little bit tough to turn, and I would like to see that be at least a little bit looser, a little bit more easy to turn, where on the Swampfox optics, not only is there a lot more grippy material that you can grab onto in order to you know, change your magnification, but it comes with an extended throw lever that you can simply mount to it in any position. So if you, you know, want to put it towards the top and then have it sit to the side or this side or whatever, you can go ahead and you can install it in any position, and that comes with it. So I thought that was pretty nice as well. With this large throw lever, it just makes things a lot easier to go back and forth quickly in your magnification range. So I thought that was nice. Now, I think that in terms of reticles, which is, I know, a very big deal to a lot of people and a big deal to me as well because I love the ACSS reticle, the Swampfox Optics Gorilla BDC, I personally think is a better reticle. Now, the ACSS reticle, I like the fact that you have that little chevron in the center of the horseshoe, and then you can use the different points on that chevron for different holdovers and so forth, and then you have some additional holdovers below that depending on which reticle that you get. With the Gorilla .BDC, the reticle is a little bit thinner and a little bit, it just makes it a little bit easier to see what's around it, where the ACSS happens to be a little bit thicker, blocking a little bit more of your target, but you can make more precise, more fine shots and still have just as quick as target acquisition with that you would with the ACSS. So the Gorilla BDC reticle, in my opinion, is probably a wash. Maybe the Gorilla BDC is a little bit better, and I would choose it just for the fact that it's not so thick. As far as illumination goes, they both get very bright. They both get daylight bright. Neither of them has specific night vision settings, so you're not really missing out there. So with the reticles, kind of a wash. They're very similar reticles, and they both have bullet drop compensation built into them. They both work with 5.56 and 308 and 7.62, depending on where you want to put your holdovers. So you can use both of them for that. These are both second focal plane scopes as well. Now, the next thing we're going to be talking about is something that you would have to feel. It's not really something that you can see, but the Swampfox Optics Tomahawk is much more robust than the primary arms 1-8. It just feels like it's got thicker material. It feels very tough. These have been rated to 1,100 Gs. So that's 1,100 times the force of gravity, meaning you can pretty much put this on just about whatever you want, and it's going to be rated to handle that. So this can handle a lot of stress. It's waterproof, it's shockproof, it's fogproof. It's just a really nice feeling optic. It's one of those things where you buy your, let's say like you buy a new camera and it feels like it's hollow, like it's cheap plastic, and then you feel one that's like nice and big and robust. It feels like, you know, it's full of components. That's kind of the feeling that you get with this one right here. Whereas the primary arms, it just does not, it doesn't have the same feel to me. It just feels lighter. It doesn't feel as durable. Now, the fact is, I've been using this one for 3 years. So again, I'm not knocking this one down. The Primary Arms is a fine scope and I've been using it for quite a while. So I'm not knocking it down. I am just saying that this one, the Swampfox Optics one, is better. But this one definitely does not feel as tough. It does not feel as robust. It does not feel as strong as the Tomahawk. Now, in terms of lens coatings, I think that's pretty much a wash. Both the lens coatings have held up just fine. You know, they're both scratch resistant, they're, you know, dust resistant and things like that. So they're both fine in terms of lens coatings. Now, the one thing that I will say is that at high magnification, so when you're up at, let's say, like 8 power on both of these, the color is gonna be so much better in the Swampfox optics. I don't know why. I don't know if just a difference in the quality of the glass. It could have something to do with the lens coatings, but the image seems sharper and my colors seem better. So when I'm using the Primary Arms, it looks fine. Everything's great. If you didn't know the difference, you would not have a problem with the Primary Arms. You would look through it, think everything's good, take your shot, hit your target, you're good. But if you were to look through these things together, both at full magnification, and try and look at a target that's kind of further down range, you would notice that the Primary Arms does have a little bit less sharpness and it's a little bit more gray than the Swampfox optics. Now, another thing that's gonna be kind of a wash here is gonna be the accuracy and tracking. So if you're gonna be tracking your turrets, so that means you take a shot and let's say you move the dial 1 MOA up. The bullet should land 1 MOA higher than it did before. And then you move it 1 MOA to the right. It should land 1 MOA to the right, bring it back down, and then again, move it back over, and you should have a square. That's the way that it should look. You should have a square. Obviously, ammo is going to play a big deal. What you're using to shoot with it is also going to make a big difference. But still, if you had the proper setup and you're able to, you know, shoot sub MOA, you should end up with a square if you track around with both of these scopes, and they both track perfectly fine. So in reality, you can't go wrong with either of these. But if I try and look at things from, you know, your perspective, from the consumer's perspective, I'm sitting here and I have a specific amount of money in my wallet and I want my money to go to something that I'm really going to enjoy, I'm going to put my money towards the Swampfox Optics Tomahawk. Again, if you're somebody who's already bought one of the Primary Arms with ACSS, you might be a little bit upset with this, but to be honest with you, if you had both of these sitting in front of you and you were looking at them just like I was, which one would you choose? The one with a bunch of features that's a little bit tougher and set up, in my opinion, a little bit better, or would you just go with the Primary Arms because that's what you already owned or something? You kind of have to look at these objectively. If, you know, if I had a specific amount of money, which one would I go with? You know, and try and be as honest and truthful as possible. And I would have to go with the Swampfox optic. To me, it's just a better 1-8 LPVO. So anyway, that hopefully answers the question from the email that I got. At the same time, hopefully if you guys are out there and you have a specific budget like that, this answered some of your questions on which one you might be able to go with, again, around that $300 price point. $389 for this one, and then with the discount code, this one comes in at like $320. You can always check my website for other discount codes and stuff like that, and links and you know, to different products and websites there too. So check that out down below. I want to thank you all very much for watching. Please like, subscribe. Have a great day.